Hello students, in the previous lecture we discussed about covalent bonding, how it is different from the ionic bonding. Whereas the ionic bonding involves the transfer of electrons, covalent bonding involves the sharing of electrons. Okay, we also saw that in covalent bonding there are the three types: single covalent, double covalent, triple covalent bonding. Also they are the non-polar and polar covalent bonding. Okay, so we will continue from where we left the previous lecture.
Oxygen. Okay, so oxygen molecule O2, the atomic number is 8, the electronic configuration is 2-6, and it wants to reach the electronic configuration of 2-8 to be stable, okay, according to the octet rule. So it needs 2 more electrons. Okay, so how is it going to get these 2 more electrons? So let us draw the Lewis structure. Okay, so oxygen, on this one we will be showing the valency shell electrons. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 5 6, okay, is going to combine with another atom of oxygen, and it is going to share 2 pairs of electrons, okay, 2 pairs of electrons to form the oxygen molecule. Okay, to form oxygen, so 2 pair of electrons means 2 covalent bonds to form the oxygen molecule. So if we show this in the orbital structure, okay, so this is the nucleus, this is the orbit. In this orbit we are showing the electrons in the orbital shell, in the valency shell. Okay, in the valency shell, so 6 electrons, all of them combine. So now what is going to happen? There is going to be a sharing of electrons. How many electrons are shared? 2 pairs. Okay, 2 pairs of electrons will be shared. Now can you tell how many electrons are there in each atom in the valency shell? Suppose in this atom, how many will be there? 2 2 4 5 6, is it? Or 4 5 6 7 8? There will be 8 electrons, because these electrons are shared. Okay, so here you are not counting only these 2 electrons, you are counting all the 4 electrons. So these 4 electrons belong to this atom and also this atom. Okay, that is why it will be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 electrons here, 8 electrons here. Both the atoms have got the octet number of electrons, therefore now they are stable. Okay, so let us look at one final example, nitrogen. N2, nitrogen molecule, atomic number 7, electronic configuration 2-5. In order to be stable, how many electrons it needs in the valency shell? It needs 3 more electrons, correct? It needs 3 more electrons. So how is it going to get these electrons? Okay, it has to share. Okay, now that is a nitrogen in the Lewis diagram structure. Okay, another nitrogen atom. Okay, both of them are going to combine. Okay, to form the nitrogen molecule. How many bonds are there? 3 bonds are there between the nitrogen atoms. Okay, in this molecule of nitrogen N2, there are the 3 covalent bonds. 3 covalent bonds means 3 pairs of electrons are being shared, correct? if we represent this in the orbit diagram structure, okay, represent this in the orbit diagram structure. One atom, another atom of nitrogen, okay, they are going to combine. How many electrons are going to overlap? Okay, three pairs of electrons, one pair, two pair and three pair. Okay, so now let us see whether they have got the octet number. Here is 6 plus 2, 8 electrons. Here also 6 plus 2, 8 electrons. They have reached the octet configuration. Okay. So, these were all examples of the non-polar covalent bonds. Next, we will be looking at the polar covalent bonds. Okay. So, examples include hydrogen chloride, HCl. Okay, hydrogen chloride. So, in the case of hydrogen chloride, hydrogen atomic number 1, it wants to reach a doublet configuration. Okay, it wants to get doublet configuration. Chlorine 17. Okay, electronic configuration 2, 8, 7. What it want to do? It want to get one more electron. Okay, in order to get the octet configuration from 7 to 8, it needs one electron. And what hydrogen needs? It needs one more electron. Okay, so both of these need one electron. Okay, so now how is the combination going to take place? Hydrogen with one electron is a combining with the chlorine. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 electrons in the valency shell. Okay, both of these will combine to share. Okay, important is what they are doing. They are not transferring, they are sharing the electron. So they are sharing this one. Okay, sharing this pair of electron. So we can show it in this way. HCl, there is a single covalent bond that is formed between both of them. We are showing this in the orbital structure. Okay, hydrogen with one electron is a combining with chlorine. Okay, 7 electrons in its outermost orbit. Then what is going to happen? There is a covalent bond formation. That means there is a sharing of electrons. Okay, hydrogen, chlorine. How many are shared? One pair is shared. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this is the hydrogen atom, correct? Hydrogen atom is having how many electrons now? It is having 2 electrons. How many electrons are there now in chlorine atom? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. So this is able to satisfy its doublet configuration and it is able to satisfy its octet configuration. Therefore, now both of them are stable. Okay. So one example is the hydrogen chloride. It is a polar covalent bond. We are telling it is a polar covalent bond. Okay. Why we are telling it is a polar covalent bond? Because there is the formation of a slight charge. Okay, there is a what we say fractional charge. Fractional charge is developed on the atoms, each of the atoms. Okay, so why? Because the distribution or sharing of the electrons, is it equal among both of them? It is not equal. Okay, so because the chlorine is much more strong, it will attract this shared electrons more towards itself. Okay, so therefore what will happen? It will get a partial negative charge and hydrogen will get partial positive charge. Okay, so in this way what will happen is, because it is not equal distribution of the electron pair, there is a polar. Okay, polar. So let us see another example. Water, H2O, water. Okay, water molecule. So in water molecule, oxygen is 8, okay, 2, 6, okay. Hydrogen we know is 1, okay, 1. So here hydrogen again want to become the doublet configuration. Here it want to become the octet configuration, okay. So therefore this needs 2 electrons, okay, and this needs 1 electron. Oxygen needs the it needs the 2 electrons to be stable, and hydrogen needs 1 electron to stable. So how is it going to combine? So there will be one showing the Lewis structure, okay, one molecule of oxygen having the 6 electrons, okay, 2 2 4 5 6, okay, plus one hydrogen here, okay. And we can also do is we will represent both of these separately for the simplicity of understanding, okay. So then what is going to happen? Hydrogen combine with, okay, oxygen, okay, hydrogen. So what is going to happen? So oxygen is forming two single bonds with two different hydrogen atoms, okay. So what is now happening is oxygen is, let us see the orbital diagram so we can understand better. So hydrogen, one electron, okay, combining with oxygen, okay, that is 1 2 3 4, okay, it is going to give rise to, now there is going to be a sharing, right, there will be a sharing of the electrons. So now this is the oxygen atom, okay. So how many are shared here? Here one pair between hydrogen, here also one pair, okay. So now this hydrogen atom is getting doublet configuration, okay, two electrons. Here it is getting 2 2 4 5 6 7 8 electrons in oxygen, okay. And again this hydrogen is getting here 2 electrons, okay. So both the hydrogens are getting their doublet configuration, this oxygen is getting its octet configuration, now they are stable. This is how it was formed. Let us see one more example, ammonia, NH3 ammonia, okay. Nitrogen 7, okay, 2 5, you know, it needs 3 more electrons to get octet configuration, and here 3 hydrogens are combining, okay, they are sharing their electrons to get this 3 to satisfy their doublet as well as to satisfy the nitrogen. So we can write quickly the Lewis structure, okay. So let us write the nitrogen, okay, 5 are there, right. So what is going to happen? 1 2 3 4 5, okay, plus hydrogen here, plus hydrogen here also, plus hydrogen, okay. So 3 places it has combined. So now what is going to happen? It is sharing 3 pair of electrons, it is sharing 3 pair of electrons with 3 atoms of hydrogen. So by showing the covalent bond we can represent in this way, okay, which is nothing but NH3 ammonia. When we represent this in the form of the orbit structure, okay, single electron, nitrogen, okay, let us show it a bit larger, okay, we'll show the total of 5 are there. So we are showing 5 electrons in its orbital shell, in its valency shell, okay, another hydrogen, single electron, another hydrogen, single electron, okay, and all of them will be combining, okay, all of them are combining so that there is an overlap of the orbit, okay, overlap of the orbits, their overlap, okay. So that is in center we have the nitrogen atom and these three are hydrogen atoms. So here is one pair, here is one pair, here is one pair, and the nitrogen itself has another pair. So this one is satisfying. Yes, it is having two electrons, duplet satisfied, duplet satisfied, duplet satisfied for all the three hydrogen atoms. What about the nitrogen? 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 electrons. So octet is satisfied in the case of the nitrogen atom.
Next, let us look at the examples of two non-polar covalent bonds. Okay. Examples of the compounds with non-polar covalent bonds. Now we are considering these two examples separately because when we are discussing about the polar covalent bonds, so there was the sharing of the electrons was not equal. Okay, now for example, let us see here, carbon tetrachloride, okay, CCl4, okay, so chlorine 17, carbon 6, so 2, 8, 7, here 2, 4, last valency is 7, requires one more electron, here is 4, it requires 4 more electrons. So therefore, what is going to happen? Carbon is sharing one electron from 4 chlorine atoms. Okay, so it is all of them are satisfying each other. Now let us see carbon in the Lewis diagram structure. Okay, carbon is combining with 4, okay, chlorine, okay, 6 plus 1, 7, 4 chlorine atoms to form the carbon tetrachloride. So what is happening is, so this is chlorine, okay, so chlorine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also chlorine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also chlorine. Okay. So basically what is happening is the chlorine, 4 chlorine atoms are combining with one carbon atom to form CCl4 molecule. Okay. Now when we look at the orbit structure, okay, so carbon having the 4 electrons in its valency shell and chlorine having the 7 electrons in its valency shell. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, how is it going to combine? So, there is a central chlorine. Okay, and it is a central carbon. And it has to share with how many? 1, 2, 3, 4 chlorine atoms. So there is a one pair each. Okay, one pair each. So, and chlorine is going to have 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is satisfying its octet. Okay, so in this way what is happening is that the sharing of electrons is taking place, but what is important here that chlorine is able to pull the electron more towards itself than the carbon, so it should be polar, but since there are 4 of them, okay, 4 chlorine atoms, and all of them are pulling the electron equally towards themselves, the overall net charge, there will be no net charge. Okay, there will be no net negative or no net positive charge will not be formed. Okay, so therefore this carbon tetrachloride, it will be the non-polar. Okay, that is very important. So you should not confuse carbon tetrachloride is non-polar even though it is having the chlorine. Okay, next is methane. Methane is another example of non-polar covalent compound. So CH4. Okay, so it can go very quickly. Okay, based upon, so carbon will show the orbit diagram first in this case. Okay, no problem. Plus there are the four hydrogens. Okay, there are the four hydrogens. They will combine such that there is the central carbon with overlapping with the four hydrogen atoms. Okay, four hydrogen atoms. So one pair in each of these orbits is shared. Okay, so what happens, you will have a central carbon that is sharing with the individual hydrogen atoms to form carbon linked with four hydrogen atoms, that is a methane. Okay, in the Lewis structure, what, how we will show it? Hydrogen, okay, with four, okay, there are four hydrogens. Okay, four hydrogens that are combined, that is combining with one carbon. Okay, so with one carbon atom to form, okay, to form the methane molecule. Okay, so in this way what is happening, hydrogen is completing its duplet and carbon is completing its octet, and here since they are similar electronegativities, both are, all of them are sharing the electrons equally among themselves, what is going to happen, there will be no net charge, so they will be non-polar in nature. Okay, so the properties of the covalent bond, they are generally low boiling point. Okay, they are low boiling point, low melting point. Okay, and they are volatile. Okay, like most of the organic compounds also, you see they are volatile. Okay, they are non-conductors, non-conductors of electricity, non-conductors of electricity. Okay, and they do not ionize. Okay, they do not ionize. Who ionize? The electrostatic bonds, whatever other, they will ionize. Okay, and since they are non-polar, mostly since they are not ionizing, therefore they are mostly insoluble in water. Okay.